V'haya b'chachet. Why would the Torah emphasize that you have sin if you don't? You have sinned if you do not give charity to the poor. The explanation is based on a discussion that happened with Rabbi Akiva and Turnus Rufus HaRasha. Turnus Rufus was one of the captains of the Romans, and he always would badger Rabbi Akiva. He didn't like Rabbi Akiva, so he would always ask him questions on the Torah, on the mitzvot. And one of the points he asks is like this: does HaKadosh Baruch Hu love those poor people? He created the poor people, right? Does he love them? Rabbi Akiva said, of course he loves them. So why doesn't he support them? Huh? How come he made them? Why did he make them poor? The poor guy lives homeless on the street. Why would HaKadosh Baruch Hu do that? Where's the good of HaKadosh Baruch Hu? So Rabbi Akiva said, well, HaKadosh Baruch Hu did that so that we should be able to escape Geinom, so we shouldn't be punished. So how so? What is that? Because when we give them tzedakah, we get merits, then everybody is able to be saved in the zechut, in the merits of the tzedakah that's being given. So Turnus Rufus HaRasha says back the exact opposite. You should be punished for giving tzedakah. I'll give you an example. Let's say you were to have a king, and the king declares or decrees that one of his subjects should be locked up in the jail, and it's not like today's jail where they get all the benefits in the world. They get Wi-Fi, they get cell phones, and whatever else they get. It's not like that. It was a jail meant you don't even get food. You get put in a pit, dark, black, nothing, and no food, no water. And the king declared that. You got to go ahead, put him in the jail. And you can imagine if now a different servant comes and he starts supplying with this individual who was basically decreed for death by the king. He starts supplying him with bread and water. How would the king react to that? He would be upset. So says Turnus Rufus to Rabbi Akiva, what are you doing? If HaKadosh Baruch Hu declared this person to be poor, why are you giving him? Why are you supplying him with tzedakah? You're going against the decree of the king. So you should be punished, not rewarded, for giving tzedakah. This is a good point. So Rabbi Akiva said back, no, you got it wrong. Let me give you the correct example that you should really bring. Imagine that the king went ahead and he declared that his son should be put in the pit. And the son was put in the pit, and another one of the king's son goes in the middle of the night and supplies him with bread and water and keeps this son alive. What do you think the king is going to be, happy or upset? Of course he's going to be happy. He doesn't want his son to die. He might have been angry at that current moment, but he doesn't want his son to die. Of course he's going to be happy that his other son, the brother, is saved the life of his son. He's going to be excited about that, and he's going to reward the person that did that. So too, Am Yisrael, we're called Banim Atem LaHashem Elokim. We're called children to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. We are the sons of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And when we give tzedakah, we are doing the will of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and therefore, we will be rewarded and saved from punishment as a result of those poor people. So we see from here, says the Chidushei Arim, what's the lesson that we could learn from here? We see that a person, because of the fact that we are called children to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, not subjects, but children to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that is the only reason we are permitted and required to give charity, to give tzedakah. Because we're children of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. That's what we see from this story.
You've just experienced another Torah class brought to you by TorahAnytime.com.